Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Imari, also known as Soul Style Beauty, and you know that my mission is to always empower women through faith with a dash of style and beauty. So today I will be reviewing the Too Faced Born This Way foundation, and this video is long overdue. I don't know if it's only me, but I went into like Sephora and Ulta and I was like, do you guys have the new shades? And they said they didn't have it. I don't know if it's me, so let me know down below. I felt like they kind of promoted it a little bit too early. I don't know what happened there, but nonetheless, I have it. I ordered it from Sephora.com. And yeah, we're just going to be doing a first impressions video today. So two things before I get started. You can always follow me on social media at Soul Style Beauty, and that's Twitter, Instagram, and all the other social media platforms of the world. And then also, I definitely wanted to remind you guys that I'm having an event in Brooklyn, August 25th. The event is called God's Girls Brunch, with the purpose of cultivating relationships and developing relationships between women, of course, with the underlying purpose of studying the word and also doing life with one another. So just setting that atmosphere for women to get to know each other in order for women to feel empowered and to study the word together. So if you want to come out, the link will be down below, but let's get into this foundation. So the shade that I got this foundation in is Chai. Usually Andrea Renee is a YouTuber that I follow, and me and her like the same skin complexion, and also Jackie Ina. So I just went with their foundation shade, and I was just like praying to God, like, I hope that this is the right foundation, just because I did get a little bit darker. I went to Mexico, it's the summer, I've been out, so I don't know, whatever. And this is the bottle here, and this foundation retails for $39. So I know that the undertone for this foundation is deep golden, so that's perfect for me. That's perfect for yellow undertones. And look at the bottle. I just feel like the bottle is super cute. I love black and gold. Love black, clearly. One thing about this bottle that I feel like I wish they would improve is the frosted packaging, just because you can't clearly see the color from looking at the bottle. So I was like, eh. But otherwise, I think that the packaging is super, super cute. So quickly, let's just go through the promises of this foundation. I have my phone here. So it's for all skin types, normal, dry, combination, oily. It's medium to full coverage, natural looking, and a radiant foundation. It says, get full undetectable coverage with this Born This Way foundation. It's infused with coconut water, which aids in delicately replenishing skin's moisture levels. It's also formulated without parabens and sulfates and all that bad stuff. And it's also vegan and cruelty free, which is also an added plus, I know, for some people. So I definitely wanted to get that in. So I'm going to take it back a notch and just start with a blank canvas, and we can see how this foundation applies and how it wears and how other products work with this foundation as well. So let's get started. Okay, so I am back with a blank canvas, just with my brow. So I am definitely gonna start off with a primer, and today I'm using the Becca Ever Matte Poreless Priming Perfector. If you know me, this is one of my old faves, and I'm using a primer, of course, just because this isn't, it's not like a mattifying foundation. This is for all skin types, so I definitely want to make sure that I use a primer. I'm really going to focus the primer on my T-zone area, so I'm not going to put it all over my face, but I am going to put it in my T-zone. And this primer is like serious business. Like, it's so good. So I'm gonna shake this foundation up and get it started. Right now I wanna just start on putting it on this side of my face, just so I show you guys what's the difference. I love when other YouTubers that I watch do that. So I'm going to apply it on one side and we'll see what happens. So I'm done applying it to this side of my face. So this is the side with foundation, and this is the side without foundation. So as of right now, I know that it did not say that it's a mattifying foundation, but no radiance to me is showing up. I just feel like it is kind of like mattifying. Maybe it's because of the primer, but I do feel like this foundation is kind of mattifying. I'm not getting that radiant look that they said that you'll get with this foundation, but to me, I still like it. I think that it has a beautiful finish. Actually, it doesn't look cakey on the skin and it looks natural. So I'm just going to apply it to this side of my face now. One thing I also wanted to mention, it's very lightweight on the face. And that's one thing that I look for in foundations where I like kind of forget that it's on, that it's not sitting heavy. It doesn't feel cakey. And that's one thing that I really wanted to know about this foundation. So loving the finish, although I'm not seeing that gradient look that they said that you'll get with this natural looking foundation, I still do love how it looks on the skin. Right now, I'm just going to do a very, very basic look, and I'll come back on camera once I'm done. Okay, so now that I'm done with my makeup, I felt like I said, this is more to me as like a mattifying foundation. I don't feel like that was just the primer, because I remembered I put primer in my T-zone. However, when I looked at certain areas of my face, I was like, oh, that seems like kind of mattifying as well. So I do think just because the foundation is oil-free, it doesn't give you like that much of a radiant look, but it gives you like a natural look. It's not too mattifying, but it doesn't give you like that dewy finish if you do like that. But I like a matte face, so that's why I'm like, ooh, I like this. And I'm not mad at the finish. Like I said, it is lightweight. I don't feel like it messed with my other products that I use on a daily. I didn't see anything like not react like it usually would when I use my usual foundation. So I do like this foundation. Like I said, I totally recommend it if you want a natural finish. Not something so dewy, but something that sits natural, something that's lightweight. I definitely do recommend this foundation. And to me, I'm like $39 is better off than like the NARS of the world, which is like $59, $60. So this is definitely one of the foundations that I'm really not mad at. So I'm gonna wear this foundation for a couple of days. So look out on the blog for a more up-to-date like review with how it wears throughout the day. But this was just a first impressions video. So if you are not subscribed, definitely go ahead and click the subscribe button down below. I want to thank you guys so much for your support and for riding it out with me. And I'll see you in my next video. Mm-hmm.